Okay, let's talk about genetic engineering. So here we are, altering the genetic code of an organism by inserting genes. These mice here have had a gene for fluorescence, glow-in-the-dark fluorescence, inserted into them. And this had to be done at the one cell stage. It couldn't be done as an adult. There's no vector that can transfer genes into that many cells. So it has to be at the one cell stage. And once you've got that gene in there, and you start to divide it into two and four and eight, then you know that that gene is going to be copied every time the cell copies itself. So genetic engineering is adding genes to other creatures, creating what's called a transgenic organism. The first thing that needs to be done is you need to identify the desired gene. Now for this, you need to know the sequence of bases, the ACCs and Gs. Stage two. Now we need to cut the gene from the donor DNA, and there's a very special enzyme called a restriction enzyme, and this cuts a precise DNA location. Here, this one cuts at this AATTC section here. This one's called EcoR1, this restriction enzyme. Once this thing cuts, you get what are called these sticky ends. And the benefit of this is that if both the recipient DNA and the donor DNA are cut with the same restriction enzyme, and you know the sticky enzymes of the sticky ends of the recipient are going to bond with the sticky ends of the donor fragment when you mix the two together. So they're going to stick, and this is what's called a palindromic sequence. We've got GAATTC and then backwards GAATTC, and this means they're going to stick together, and that's the benefit of using these restriction enzymes. We've got a bacterium here, and it's got a bacterial plasmid. This ring of DNA here is a bacterial plasmid, and it's separate from the main chromosomal DNA, and it can replicate independently. So our next step is to use that same EcoR1 restriction enzyme to chop this plasmid open. Next, we have to glue it in. So here we are, we've got our gene of choice, we've got our plasmid, we've chopped them out with our restriction enzymes, and another enzyme called a DNA ligase acts as a glue to stick those sticky ends together. So our geneticists have got sort of a tool bag of scissors and glue, molecular scissors and glue in the form of restriction enzymes and DNA ligases. And now that plasmid can be inserted back into the bacteria, and that bacteria is now ready to express that gene. Stage five. Now it's important that scientists know whether or not a bacterial plasmid has been successfully transferred into the bacteria. Now, in this diagram here, you can see one bacterium which has successfully taken up our plasmid and one that's not. Now, the way you know which ones have and which one hasn't, you don't want to be growing this one up because this one hasn't got our gene. It's not going to express anything. It would be a waste of time. So, what you do is, along with the gene of interest, you also put in there a gene for resistance to an antibiotic. Then you grow these bacteria on an agar plate, and this agar plate, bacteria food essentially, has also got an antibiotic, ampicillin. Ampicillin kills bacteria. It's going to kill this one because this one has not got the gene for antibiotic resistance, ampicillin resistance. However, our plasmid with our desired gene has also got the ampicillin resistance gene in it, so they will all survive. And the next day, when we come back to our agar plate and we see it's covered in bacteria, we will know that they all have our lovely little plasmid in, because that's got the resistance gene in it and it's got our desired gene in it as well. And that's called assaying. Stage six, incubate. We're ready to grow them up. Now we know the bacteria have all got our plasmids in. We're ready to grow them up, put them in an incubator. And the great thing about bacteria is they divide very, very quickly. And every single one of these bacteria will have our little bacterial plasmid in, and they'll all be happily making our little protein. For example, the best known protein created using recombinant DNA technology is insulin. Insulin is needed to help diabetic people regulate their blood sugar levels. So this is really useful, a useful bit of technology. And the more and more genes we can identify, the more and more we can produce using this technique. Now, all life on Earth, from bacteria up to blue whale, uses the same ATCG4-based nucleotide system. And the good thing about that is that we will know that our gene is going to work in any organism. It's going to work in any organism because it's all read the same using the same genetic material in the same way. And this is why, going back to my initial slide, we can take a GFP protein, a green fluorescence protein from a jellyfish, and insert it into a mouse. And we know it's going to work. Okay, there we are. That's genetic engineering. Thank you for watching.